Welcome to Reginald ESQ. I'm Underhook and this is my review of the Tier 2 German light tank, the Panzer II. Although it's got a Kpfw in its name and I don't know what that stands for, so if you do know, feel free to put it in comments and let me know. Is this tank any good? Yes, it's a good tank. I quite like it. A lot of fun and a good all-rounder tank. If you're a beginner, good tank to get. It's maneuverable, has a good gun, and has good armor. Okay, let's get into the review. It has 170 hit points, which is quite good. Weighs from 9 to 11 tons, which is pretty good, about average. 160 horsepower from the engine, and has a speed limit of 40 kilometers an hour. Now that speed isn't as fast as quite a lot of the light tanks are a lot faster than that, but it's not super slow either. It's not a bad speed. It's okay. Its traverse speed of 40 though is pretty slow, but it's slow compared to the others. It's not actually slow as such. The armor I'll talk about in Tank Inspector, but it is good armor. The turret traverse of 44 though is very good. The only tank that is better than that, the only light tank, is the Russian T-26. I'm pretty sure that's the only one. Other than that, it has it tops the turret traverse speed. So you won't find tanks getting behind you and you not being able to turn your gun quickly enough. You definitely can in this tank. Has a view range of 320, which is sort of equal top. It shares that with the British light tanks and the American light tanks, but it is better than the rest of them. So it is quite good, that 320 view range. And the Signal range of 455 is, I'm pretty sure, the best of any of the Tier 2 light tanks. Now, when you combine that view range and signal range with the fact that this tank also has a little bit above average camouflage, it's actually a pretty good scout tank. So it can see a fair way, and it can also radio that information back to the other tanks whilst remaining camouflaged. And it's also got good armor, so if you do get caught out, you can sort of still fight your way out of it. Now, that said, let's have a look at the grind for this tank in the research tree. When you start off, you get two different guns, a choice of either gun. So you can either choose the gun on the left there or the gun on the right. The left is a 30, right is a 38. The guns are exactly the same, except that the gun on the right, the 38, has some improvements. So there's absolutely no reason whatsoever to use the gun on the left. All the guns available on this tank are autoloaders. You cannot get a gun that is not an autoloader. It is a 10-shot magazine, and in this gun on the left, it has a 0.21 shell loading time, 3.9 seconds to load the whole magazine, penetration of 23, damage 11 per shell, and 0.59 accuracy and 1.7 aiming time, which is excellent. With the 38, which is the gun you would use, you'd be crazy to use the 30, I think, because there's nothing better about it. You get a 0.13 between each shell, which means you basically deliver all 10 shells in just over a second. And it's 3.9 seconds to reload that magazine still. 23 pen with 11 damage, and if you use premium ammo, you double your penetration to 46, which is a big difference in penetration. Accuracy is 0.57. It's not very good accuracy. In fact, it's pretty terrible accuracy. It really sprays the ammo. And aiming time of 1.6 seconds, which is sensational. Now, it does fire them in, if you just quickly click your mouse button, it'll only fire two rounds at a time. So it's 2 second bursts. Or if you hold your button down, it fires all 10 pretty much like bang, 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 like that. Now, the problem is it fires two shots, then it loses its aim and has to start re-aiming again. Now, you're probably not going to sit there and go two shots like that, because you're exposed for too long. So most people are just going to let all 10 shots go at once. And because it loses its aim, and its aim is only 0.57 accuracy anyway, it becomes quite inaccurate. However, at close range, it doesn't matter. They'll all hit anyway. Okay, so that's that gun. Then what you do is you move on to this gun. You don't need to get the turret to get this gun. And this is the gun you want. It's same gun. It's the Flak 38. It's 10 shells in the magazine. 0.13 is the same. 0.39 to reload a magazine is the same, but the penetration is much better. So the penetration is now 39 for the standard shell, Same damage, 11, but 39 is really good. And with premium ammo, it goes to 51. So you don't need to use premium ammo much, only really probably T18s if you're at range. If you're close to a T18, you can shoot the upper plate, no problem. But you will struggle with the rest of the tank, even the sides. So it's bit you're better off if you've got premium ammo for those sort of tanks. Or for some tier 3 tanks, it's good to have premium. The accuracy is 0.45, which is a little better, but it's still not great. But at this tier, not many tanks are accurate anyway. And at aiming time of 1.6 is fantastic. So a good gun, very good gun. The turret is well worth upgrading, however. The standard turret has 30 armor at the front and 15 and 15. This one has 30, 20, 20, which is a bit better. But the main thing is the turret traverse speed goes from 39 to 44, which is a big increase and really well worth it. Also, the view range goes from 290 up to 320, so that's well worth it as well. And it's the same weight, so you're not adding any weight with the turret, so it's a really good upgrade. You definitely want to get the radio and the engine. I didn't bother going to the second engine because it's less than a 10% power upgrade. It's, you wouldn't even notice it. I went straight to the third engine, which it's a little bit better. And the tracks, it takes your track traverse from 35 to 40, so that's well worth doing as well because it's a bit of a, that's probably it's one of its weaknesses is its track traverse, this tank. So that's the gun and the grind. What else can we tell you about this tank? The gun depression is 10 degrees, which is very, very good, so you can hill fight with this tank. A lot of the tanks at this level, though, do have 10 degrees, but still it does have it, and has 20 degrees elevation, which is also quite good. I have binoculars fitted and a camouflage net fitted. I also have vents fitted to try and counteract my crew. My crew is not fully trained, so just bear in mind when you're watching the replay that the accuracy and the speed and handling of the tank won't be as good as it would be if you had a fully trained crew. My commander here is at 91%. This guy's at also 91, and no, this guy will be at a bit more than that. This guy's about 96%, sorry. This guy's at 96%, and this guy's at about 85%, 86%. So he's a loader. So yeah, it's not going to be as good as it could be. I carry a small repair kit, and I carry a large repair kit and a large first aid kit because those kits, the big kits, give you some protection. The big first aid kit gives about 15% protection to your crew from injuries, and this protects your modules by 10% just by having them on board. And I use the small one to repair any damage, but I don't use it much. Okay, that's about it. I think we can probably get into the gameplay now. It is a good tank, and I'll show you in Tank Inspector the good angles to angle your tank, but it is well worth angling this tank as well. Just be aware that your accuracy does drop off quite quickly with at range with this gun, so just watch that. But other than that, it's a good tank. Into Tank Inspector. So here we are in Tank Inspector, looking at our lovely Panzer II. There she is. Now, this is one of the rare occasions where the armour is actually better than advertised. It's usually worse than advertised, but in this case it's better. Let's have a look at it in colourised view, it's easier to see. So, what they tell us is it's 30 at the front, I think it's 20 at the side and 15 at the back. I think that's what they tell us. But this section here, as you can see right now, is 30mm. That's what they advertise. But these red sections here, this is why I wouldn't bother shooting at this plate, is actually 55mm, which is very, very strong for a tier 2 light tank. So that's 55, those red panels. And those red panels pretty much take up more room than does the rest of the upper armor there. So it's 30 and 50, so that's very good. The other thing is, the lower plate is 35mm. Now, normally, especially on the upper tiers with German tanks, everybody knows that the upper plate on German tanks is very tough indeed, but everyone shoots their lower plate because that's their weakness. Well, on this one, the lower plate's the strongest, well, one of the strongest bits of the tank, 35mm. And so it's advertised as 30, but you've got 35. This section here, though, is weak. The upper plate is only 20mm, but even so, 20mm, it's not too bad. It is very steeply angled, but we do have a little driver's hatch here, which is quite weak at 15. So if I was shooting this tank, I would probably aim for this upper plate, especially this hatch if you can, if your gun's accurate enough. The other thing is the turret is 30 at the front, as advertised. However, the mantlet is quite weak at 20 mils, which is a bit of a surprise. So that would be a very good area to penetrate if you get the chance. Now, normally mantlets like this, the mantlet is stronger than the turret. So I think a lot of people probably won't shoot at it because they'll be scared of the mantlet being strong, but it's actually a weakness. That's going to be hard to remember, but it's a very unusual armor layer. Side of the tank is 20 mils pretty much all around. There's little hatches which drop down 18. This one's 15, but really they're going to be hard to hit. Rear of the tank is nothing much, 15 and 10 down the bottom. So it's pretty weak on the rear and the sides. But really the side turret and armor being 20 means you probably can angle this tank a little bit. But as you can see from here, we've got a little bit of angled armor here. So that's not a good side to angle. So if you angle, if you're showing them your left side, you're going to be weaker than if you show them your right side because of the pre-angled plate. So for example, if I angle here, where I get my, what do we got here? That's equivalent 30. How can it be equivalent 30 when it's angled? Let's go over here. Equivalent 30, but it's equivalent 32. This is, no, so that's too much for an angle. So there it says 28, but if I come back to here, it says 22. So you got to be careful of that. So on this side, you really don't, you can't angle very much. Probably even that's about as much as you can. If you're angling on this side though, so you got 32 it says there, and 30 here. So I can afford to angle a little bit more. About a 30 there, 30. So you can angle about like that, and pretty much be maximizing your front side armor. So you can side scrape in this tank, but you can do it better when you show them the right side than when you show them the left side if they happen to shoot at that spot, which they probably will because it's presented straight at them. The other unusual thing about this is the cupola is actually not weak. It's 30 mils of armor as well. So that's quite good. So quite a well armored tank, and I have bounced a lot of shots with this tank. You will, especially other autoloaders. It is quite good, and I have done a bit of angling. It is worth angling this tank. It does pay off. So yeah, into some gameplay. All right, the map is Ensk. I'm in my tier 2 Panzer 2. It's a tier 3 match. Approximately half the tanks on each side are tier 3. So it's a good chance to see what the tank can do. There's a couple of T-18s on the other side. I always look for those side of the game because I know they are hard to penetrate. So I make up in my mind at this stage already. I say, okay, if I see a T-18, I will consider loading premium ammo if it's on an angle that I don't think I can penetrate it on. So I pre-prepare that in my mind that as soon as I see a T-18, get ready to load different ammo. And there's also, I always take note at the start of every game, there's a couple of artillery, so I know I need to be a bit careful about if I'm spotted out in the open. So I'm just trying to sneak along this area here, see if I can catch anybody out. Nobody wants to play at the moment. Now somebody on the other side, you can see a minus one in blue. So somebody on the side has already killed one of their own team. Not a good start for them. Oh, what? Hang on a second. That's our team. Somebody on our team has killed one of our own players. A T-18 has killed one of our own guys. So might have been an accident because the T-18 firing HE, you might have just hit someone on a bad area. It's also a terribly inaccurate gun, so it could have been an accident. Penetration. Critical hit. Okay, so unload on this light Vic, a very lightly armored tank. Enemy is hit. Enemy armor is damaged. Pretty hard to not penetrate, but unfortunately he's also very fast. Now he's a M2 medium. This is a tier 3 medium tank, but it doesn't have very good armor. Has a good gun though. Don't know why he didn't shoot back. He seemed to have been unaware of our presence. I can't, oh there he is. We've spotted him again. Also doesn't have very good camouflage. And I've got a feeling, I've got a camouflage net, I've got a feeling maybe he can't see me. Maybe he's got terrible view range as well, or he could be just a brand new player who just doesn't know what's going on, of course. There could be that. There's a Chini. I have reviewed the Chini, and yeah, it's on fire. If you watch my reviews on Japanese tanks, they catch fire all the time. And they're very easy to damage modules on Japanese tanks. They're not great in that respect. Well, the enemy's only got two tanks left. There's one of them, a medium two. Now, I've got to watch. A medium two at close range is very dangerous. So, probably don't need to go after him, but hey, you got to have fun. So I keep moving and I have no intention of stopping anywhere near him. He does have a slow turret traverse. He gets a hit on me and he only does 4 damage. He's firing HE. Oh, what a mistake firing HE. He must have hit a good part of my armor with HE and didn't do much damage, only 4. Someone else got the kill. Yeah, big mistake. Good against really lightly armored tanks, but really that, as far as I can remember, that tank has a pretty good gun. Armor-piercing ammunition gun, so I don't know why he's... Oh well, who knows. Probably just trying it out. It is tier 2 after all. Look, I'm not going to make it in time to get this artillery. That's the only thing they've got left, so we'll just finish it here. Okay, so we won. It was second class mastery badge on that game. Yeah, not bad. We actually hit a couple of tier 3 tanks, I think. Let's have a look at the next screen. And a T18, surprise, surprise, finished on top. And he actually got 8 kills, so he dominated the game and probably pretty much won it for us, doing 931 damage, which is a lot of damage at tier 2. He did a lot of experience, 2,100. He had an awesome game. I did 427 damage, 500. That's pretty good. So we came number 2 on our team for damage and experience. And that was a T82 on our team that did a team kill there. So I don't know what that was about because, well, anyway. Next screen. And we can see that. We fired 104 shots, so you do go through the ammo with these autoloaders. Direct hits 49, so it does spray a fair bit like a shotgun. Penetration's 35, so 35 out of 49 is actually quite good. I'm quite happy with that. Damage 427, hits received 1, penetration 1. That was at 4 damage from that tank at the end there. Enemy spotted 1, damaged 4, destroyed 1. And damage due to our assistance was 64, a little bit of spotting damage. And really good profit margin. So it was 11,920 income, and we made 11,588 profit. So, of course, we didn't need much repairs in a tank, but the ammunition for 104 rounds was only 312 coin, which is very cheap. Experience-wise, we did 569, I think it says, with a premium that came to 853, and that was enough for us to get the second class badge, I believe it was. So let's go on to the next game. The map is Province. I'm in my Panzer II. It's a tier 2 game. Approximately, so all of the tanks are tier 2, except we both have 2 tier 1s, medium 1, and we have a T1 and they have a MS1. We're on the losing side of the map. I call this the losing side of the map because most of the time the team that starts on this side of the map loses the game. It's just quite a bit more difficult to win from this side. We have, I think, 2 T18s on our side. The enemy has 3. Penetration. Or are they T28s? I'm not sure. Let me have a quick look here. It's a bit easier to read it here. We have 2 T18s, they have 3 T18s. Okay, Panzer 2, same tank as us. Long range, 387 meters, but as you can see, none of our shots penetrated, and we're shooting to the side, even though he's angled. So there you go, armor is good. And while I was chatting away, we hit that T2 medium before as well. penetrating it four times. Now, in this, I've played 23 games now in this tank. It doesn't take many to get to mastery in tier 2. Elite in tier 2. We've got a shot here. Oh yeah, just the edge of him sticking out there.
That one didn't go through.
Didn't go through. A bit long range even for that. Yeah, so I do like it. It's good fun. Now, out of the 23 games, my win rate is only 39%, so not very good, even though I have been having a lot of bad luck since Christmas with games, but not really reflective of the performance of the tank. It is a very good tank, and even though my win rate's only 39%, my destruction ratio is 1.44 and my damage ratio is 1.67, and my efficiency has been going up. So, now, you can see here, I'm aiming. Now, watch what happens when to the indicator when I switch to the frontal plate. Look at that, it goes green. See that? That's the spot to hit a TO there. You can see there that they all went in. I've just now switched to premium ammunition. Actually, I'm sorry, that round that I fired at the T18 there was premium ammunition, that first lot. And I've just fired a second lot of premium. Now I've switched back to normal ammo now. But yeah, that upper frontal plate is a place to shoot those two teams if you can. Okay, Cruiser 3 doesn't have great armor. So standard ammo at this range, especially on the side, goes through no problem. Yeah, so even though not a very good win rate, really good damage and destruction rate, considering what it is. Oh, he commits suicide. By accident, I think. So it is a better tank. So if you're looking at my stats going, oh, you know, it's not that good. I just didn't have much luck with the teams I was on, I guess. There's a Panzer II just like us. Do I risk moving out and possibly blowing my cover? Yeah, okay. That's good. It's too good in a shot.
We didn't penetrate their armor.
Okay, Panzer II, just like us. We're getting shot at now. Interestingly, we couldn't penetrate it. Now, once you get spotted, this is a dangerous spot to be in because artillery will start going after you. So that's why I was being very careful not to get spotted before. Oh, T2 medium. Thank you. Yes, please. Not too much trouble penetrating them. Haven't got sixth sense, so it's hard to tell when spotted. But now if I go forward of this bush, there's a good chance I'm spotted. Especially if I fire. If I go forward of the bush and then fire, I'll probably definitely get spotted. If I fire from the bush, maybe not. Because my tank does have a pretty good camouflage ratio and view range is not great. M1 medium, terrible armor. It's only a tier 1 tank, so I feel a bit sorry for that guy there. He's driving out in the open, so he can't last very long, surely. Well, looks like he's going to make it across. And there's the M2 light, which is their other tier 1 tank. Oh, no, it's not. It's not a tier 1, is it? M2 light? No, it's not. It's a tier 2 tank. Very, very fast tank, the M2 light American tank, yeah. He's dead now anyway. Now, see that area there? I'd love to camp up there, and I'm sure other people do too, so I just spray some ammo up there just in case someone's up there. The game after this, I got my mastery badge for this tank, and I was camped up there. And just pretty much most of the game I was camped up there, just blasting stuff. And I think I got a Confederate badge and mastery up there. You will get a lot of, potentially you get a lot of Confederate badges in this tank because it penetrates fairly well, but it sprays a lot of the shots, so you're not really often putting all your shots into a tank, especially if you're at range. So you damage a lot of tanks, but don't necessarily destroy a lot. To destroy tanks, generally you need to be fairly close so that all of your shots are going in. So if you played this tank a lot, like you really liked it, I could see you get a lot of Confederates, unless you got right in close. It's a bit hard on this map to get in close. Looks like I might need to speed this up a little bit. I'm going to go to 2x. Haven't got a shot on that Chini. The Panzer 2 down there and a T-7 combat car. Oh, T-18, okay. Oh, now that was standard ammunition that time. And none of those shots went in. It was long range though. We probably got spotted then too, because we came forward of the bush to fire. The bush does lose a lot of camouflage if you fire within 15 metres of it anyway. But it doesn't lose all of its camouflage, I don't think. I think it drops to about 15% of what it was. But the other thing though is if I move forward and fire, my camouflage net won't have had time to activate, so... And then I fire, so I'm really losing a lot of camouflage. Alright, the Panzer II's dead. The T-7 combat car is still going. It's 7-9. We're losing, so we're down by 2 tanks. So we don't penetrate, but we do get a critical hit. Speed up to 2x again. Not a lot going on. Everybody's waiting now. It's 6 minutes to go. And with about 5 minutes, or say 4.5 minutes, by 4.5 minutes people will have to make a move. If they don't make a move, nobody can win, because you're going to have to take some time to count. There's the Chini wall. We just lost another tank, so we're down 7-10. It's not looking good for us now at all. I haven't got a shot on him. I'm back down to 1x speed again now. Something's blowing up. Was that our artillery firing? Okay, T-18's on the move. I'm going to have a shot here. I'm loading premium ammo. It's my last 10 shots of premium ammo. And we only get one penetration out of it. Now I've got to have another shot. Now I've only got standard ammunition left. Hopefully we can hit the frontal plate or do something as he goes through. He actually stopped, only one or two of my shots went in. We'll have another go. We penetrated him that time. Now, we actually got hit by an MS-1. That bounced. Let's have a look. So I'll stop that. We'll have a look. Where did it hit? You can see there it's hit the mantlet. The mantlet, remember, is a bit weaker. It's only 20 mils, but it bounced. It looks like it went in there, but it definitely bounced. Okay, let's start that up again. So... yeah, there you go. So that's only a tier 1 tank though, so it wouldn't have had very good pin anyway. Ouch. Artillery hits us for 158. Almost kills us. We've got 12 health left. Also took out my engine. Now, I'm too scummy at this late stage in the game to repair my engine. I don't want to spend the money. Now, that rush evened it up. It was 10-all, but they just got another one of ours, so now it's 10-11. Now, I'm in two minds here, whether to stay and defend the artillery or move to the cap. Now, we've just lost a T-18 there, which is not good. So now they're two up again, so it's 3 tanks versus 5. I'm assuming they're going to rush the cap, but I'm also worried they may come up this side and our artillery will be exposed and left on its own. So I'm in two minds about where to go. I'm just going to speed it up here to 2x. Tank is very slow with the knocked out engine. So only 2 minutes left, or 3 minutes left. So the other team is going to have to do something soon if they want to win. They've got five tanks, so the momentum is with them. They're the ones who need to move. Okay, so we've spotted this MS1. Tier 1 tank. Now, I could have probably taken a shot at his cupola there, but if lucky, one shot would have hit. We would have done, what, 11 damage. It's not worth blowing our cover for that. If they're going to cap, they're going to have to come down into the cap circle anyway, where I'll have a good shot at him from here. And we've got the TAT on the other side, so we'll basically crossfire him. Okay, my worst fear has happened, and the T-18 has come up and is going for our artillery. So I've got to move back there now, but I really should have repaired my engine, and I'm too slow. Looks like our guy ran down the hill to get away, and a T-18's followed him down and rammed him from the look of that. And then looks like our T-18 nailed their T-18, so that's our guys on 6 kills. So it's the two of us against four of them now. So there's no point, we can't cap, there's no time to cap anyway. All we can do now is hope, see if they try and cap and try and nail them when they do. Okay, the MS1's come down now to try and cap. I just noticed there too is another tank off to the left, but I haven't had a chance to see what it is. That's a Chini, okay. We set him on fire.
Enemy is hit.
And we managed to finish him off. Let's see if we can get this Chini now. As you can see, reload is very quick on this gun. There, can't get a shot. Follow him along, see if we can. There he is.
Alright, beautiful.
So now it's two tanks all. But there's no way we can get to their cap. There's no way they can cap in time, even if they get here. And they're not going to come now after seeing that. So that's the end of the game. So, ended up being a draw. We managed to get a Confederate badge, and we got our Class 1 Mastery badge there as well. Looks like we did a fair bit of spotting as well there. So we've got the next map, and we finished on top for experience, although not for damage. Our T-18 there did 545 and got 6 kills. And on the other side, the T-18 got 7 kills with over 500 damage as well. So T-18s really do rule. Tier 2, but we did very well. And let's have a look at the next screen, and we fired 204 shots, of which 103 were direct hits. I'm pretty happy with that considering the range that we were firing from. And of those, 46 penetrated, which are also pretty happy considering the range. We received 3 hits, 2 penetrations, managed to bounce one, although it was only off a tier 1 tank. And enemy spotted 5, damaged 8, destroyed 2. Also did some good assistance damage, 192, that's pretty good at tier 2. And 12,000 plus courageous resistance, because we got an award. And we still only made 639 profit because we used 30 rounds of premium ammunition on the T-18s. Now you can see there our experience was 417 plus the 276.4 courageous resistance gave us a total of 693 without premium. Now that experience was enough for the Class 1 Mastery badge. I did have another game where I got Mastery where I was camped on that ridge where I took some pot shots at. I told you I did some blind firing and I like to camp there. I camped there in a game and got Mastery and I did 848 experience. And that was enough to get Mastery, and I got a Confederate on that game as well, I think. Alright, there you go. I hope you enjoyed the gameplay. Thank you for watching my review of the Panzer II. Very good tank, really liked it. A lot of fun driving it. I may even keep it for a while and just drive it a bit just for fun. If you like the review, please give it a thumbs up, because it does help me out. And if you want to see any more reviews, please subscribe to ReginaldESQ. While you're out there driving tanks, have fun!